This is Mr. P from WrestleZone, and I want you to embrace the chaos of OSW TV Takeover right here on Wave Radio.
You're listening to waveradio.org.uk. Wave Radio.
Hi, this is Billy from the OSW TV podcast and OSW TV everywhere. This week, or this time, in time land, we've got three interviews for you. We've got one with senior referee for WrestleZone, Denzel Law, the tag team champions of WrestleZone, Mr. P and Caden Garrick, and the undisputed champion of WrestleZone, Scotty Swift. What I'm going to do is we're going to play the interviews, and in between each interview, we're going to have a little bit of an ad to hopefully drum up some business. And I don't know if you want to have an ad on any of these podcasts in the future, just let me know and get in touch with me at voiceofosw@gmail.com. But the first one we're going to have here is with Denzel Law. We're going to have the tag champions and then the heavyweight champion. So, enjoy. I'm here with WrestleZone's senior referee, Denzel Law. How's it going?
Hello. I'm very fine. How are you?
Not bad. No one's actually asked me how I am so far. I'm great. So, we're in Keith tonight. Haven't been here for 3 years. Did you referee the last?
I did indeed. It's always a great crowd in Keith, and we're very much looking forward to coming back.
You've been with WrestleZone for a while, of course, senior referee. So
yes.
You've seen many highlights and probably lowlights as well, but we'll focus on the highlights. So many matches over the years in small halls, huge venues like the Aberdeen Anarchy Beach Ballroom. Speak about what highlights have you had in your...
Well, there's been many, many highlights. I mean, I've been referee at WrestleZone since June 2011, so I've done 400 matches. I've counted them all, but a lot of matches. I think my own personal highlight was at the Beach Ballroom. I refereed a British Rules match between Aspen Faith and Councillor legend Len Ironside. That was probably my career highlight so far, although I've done so many matches that... I've been privileged to be the best seat in the house for matches like at the last ballroom, you know, Scotty Swift versus Joe Coffey, X-Pac, you know, a lot of big names.
Excellent. Yeah, of course, you were talking about the British Rules. So that's, was it 1,200 people? You were there.
Absolutely.
Proper old school style, shirt and tie, with Len Ironside and Aspen Faith, which I was front row for. It was phenomenal.
Yeah.
I didn't expect it to be that good, if I'll be totally honest, because Len's age.
Len can still go. Len went, yes. Len can still go.
Absolutely. So there are many pitfalls when it comes to being a referee, of course. Massive boots from wrestlers being
yes.
one of them. So you do. I've seen you take your hits in the time. How do you prepare for matches nowadays?
Well, basically, myself and Mikey, we have our own room backstage for... We get prepared, we get our matches, what we're going to do, get in the right mindset. And it's very difficult because the guys are moving so fast to just stay out of the way, make sure we're enforcing the rules all the time. There's a lot of people that break the rules, you know, whether it's behind our back or right in front of us. And we've got to just lay down authority because we've been put there by WrestleZone management to ensure everyone's safe and that there is a result at the end of it. So it's a very tough job. I think it's tougher than people maybe think it is when they watch, but it's really difficult. You need a lot of training before you can be a referee.
So I've seen a lot of referees over time transition into other occupations. It's not the word. Jobs. I'll go for that. Like managers or even wrestlers themselves. Do you have any vocation to do either of those things?
I'm very privileged just to be a referee, and I want to do it as long as I can. It's amazing to be out there in front of a crowd more than once. So, you know, the wrestlers, they go, they do the match, they try to win, but they're out once. I could be out 2, 3, 4, 5 times in a night doing what I love. I love refereeing. It's a tough job. You know, occasionally I get hit if I'm in the wrong position, but I just love doing it, and I want to do it as long as possible. I wouldn't want to transition to anything else, because I just love refereeing.
Excellent. Well, thank you for taking your time to speak to us, and good luck in Keith Knight. Hopefully,
thank you very much,
hopefully you can avoid anyone coming your way.
I will do my best.
And enforce the rules, of course.
Thank you.
Do you ever find yourself peckish? Do you ever think that you need food as soon as possible? Well, if you're in Elgin and you're looking for some cracking food for low, low prices, go to Gemma's Lunchbox. Gemma's Lunchbox in Elgin.
Okay, so here I am sitting with the WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. If you want to introduce yourself individually.
Well, I'm Mr. P.
And I'm Caden Garrick.
So you just won the titles quite recently. So how does it feel to actually hold gold in WrestleZone?
Well, it feels pretty good. It's unexpected, for one. We didn't know what we were going to be doing at the Northern Hotel. It was Battle of the Nations. And next thing you know, I find out I'm in a tag team match. And my partner is Caden Garrick. And so we were definitely, no one thought we could win it that night. And then out of the blue, we did it.
Yep. It was a shock for me.
I mean, we've like trained together a few times, you know, we like through the school, we sort of came up together. I wouldn't say we were the best of friends. We were more associates. We trained with each other, you know, we tried things out. And then, of course, thrown in a tag team, I thought, okay, well, why not? And from my perspective, from my, sorry, point of view, it's more like I'm teaming with somebody who's undefeated. This is going to be okay, you know? So, yeah. So I don't know how he felt about teaming with me. Would love to know that. Be honest, Caden.
I'm not going to lie to you.
Just be honest.
I didn't really feel it to begin with.
Okay. Okay.
I tend to keep myself to myself, as you know.
I do.
But when I got here, realised that I'm in a team with Mr. P. And to be honest, there could be a lot worse people to be in a team with.
But, well, I think that's a compliment. I'll take that.
It is a compliment.
Jeez. But, you know, don't hold back, bro. God.
But no, it's all right. It's yeah, brings a lot of energy. Brings a lot of. He's got fight in him. He's got heart.
Our relationship is evolving, strong. As you can see. It's evolving. It's going to evolve over time. And we're here for the long run. I mean, we won those titles out of nowhere. All of a sudden, Mr. P, Caden Garrick, WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, and it's like, you know what? We're just going to enjoy the ride, and we're here for the long run.
So with that, then, do you have a team name yet?
See, that's the thing. You know, it was only a couple of weeks ago we thought, we need entrance music, you know, because we could have done the whole mishmash of music. He's got the bagpipes and hey, you know, I'm a Highlander, you know your thing. And then me, I got the, you know, the, hey, we've got the hard rock saliva, you know, that's what you, all these good indie guys, they want the saliva, they want the shine down. So I had the saliva going on. So we thought about mishmashing it. But, and then we finally picked a tune. Don't ask me who it's by. Okay.
I'll
find out. Tonight.
You will find out. Yeah. But it was just one of those things. Like we listened to a bunch of tunes on an iTunes playlist, and that one just stood out. I was like, yeah, that's the one. That's the one. So, like I say, we're evolving at the moment. We're still just Mr. P and Caden Garrick. But if anyone has any suggestions, appropriate suggestions, yeah. Of course, please, yeah, feel free to message OSWTV.
Yeah.
What the name for us. Maybe you have a name for us.
I didn't think of any off the top of my head. I was trying to think of something maybe a bit cool, but nothing.
Yeah,
I think you're in the same boat as us.
Yeah.
And like, every time me and Dave are like, there's similarities to us is in our personas and stuff like that. But we are different. We do have different dislikes and likes.
Yeah.
And a lot of the time it usually ends up in a little bit of bicker and argument.
Yeah, the only thing we have in common is wrestling.
Yeah.
But that's what I love about wrestling. I mean, you'll see it when you come to shows and whoever you're sitting next to, you know, you don't know who's going to go at a wrestling show. It's such a wide variety of people, but the only thing that bonds you is wrestling. That's the only thing that me and Caden have in common is wrestling.
That's all you need, really. You don't need to go for drinks after the shows as long as you're got a chemistry in the ring. That's all it really
exactly.
And I think that chemistry is coming.
Yeah, I mean,
I think in time it will come. The more we wrestle together, I think stuff will start to evolve between us, and it'll just gel.
Well, I mean, I'm still waiting for him to invite me round to his house for a drink, meet the girlfriend. But maybe you're waiting for me to do the same thing, yeah? Maybe I've got to do the inviting. Is that right?
I don't think I'll take it over.
I hear you have a bigger house, so feel free to invite me over. Maybe we'll... All right, after the show tonight, what are you doing tonight?
Maybe, Dave.
What are you doing after the show tonight? What are you doing after the show?
I'm going home.
See? You don't even think about, you know, oh, come on over, Dave. We'll watch the X Factor rerun. It's a good show. It is a good show.
I don't watch it.
You don't watch the X Factor? It's really good. There's like people... There's like a guy... Oh, there's a guy who's got like half a leg, you know, one eye, and he's like, sings like an angel. I cry. I cry every time I watch the X Factor. You wouldn't cry, would you?
No.
See, that's where we differ. Unbelievable.
So with that as well, as you said near the start, you're quite inexperienced as a tag team. Mm-hmm. But I'm sure that you're going to get quite a lot of experience because you're currently a little bit of rivalry with the Rejected, Chris Archer and Mickey Vago. I can't remember. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So you've got them, and you've also got Sterling Oil hanging about, which I'm sure they'll be looking to... get in at some point. So how does it feel being so inexperienced but having such a wealth of experienced tag teams in front of you?
There's a massive target on your chest when you've got a title. It doesn't matter if it's a world title, if it's tag titles, you've got a target, so anybody's got to want to come and get them. But me, I don't know about you, Dave, but me, I invite anybody. I don't care who you are. Sterling Oil, they're Rejected, I don't care. That titles are going nowhere.
It's funny as well, like we had a match with the Rejected last week in Bankery and we watched it back and it's like we really okay, I'll be honest with you, like as a team, as a unit, we suck. Okay, we really do suck. You watch what the Rejected did in these fast tags, they're in and out, they're dominating us as a team. Now, when it comes to individual action, hey, I got the upper hand on both of them, and so does Caden Garrick. We're experienced singles wrestlers. Caden Garrick has never actually had his shoulders pinned to the ground, okay? That's how good this guy is. But see, when it comes to tag team, we know we have a lot to learn. But you know what that is? That's pressure. And we love that pressure. And with the titles on the line, every time we're out there, that's the type of pressure we embrace. And that's what it's all about. So that's why, yes, Rejected, Sterling Oil, Melistos, whoever they are, we're ready. We'll embrace it. Let's go. Let's fight. Let's fight and see what happens.
Perfect. Well, good luck tonight. When this goes out, of course, it'll be the week after, and they'll have a full review. So hopefully you've won, which I can't see why you wouldn't win. Sorry, just tell us who your opponents are again.
I am facing William Sterling.
Yeah,
good luck. Sterling Oil.
Yeah.
And first time.
And I've got Chris Archer, one of the Rejected.
One of the Rejected.
So just looking to get my hands on that little grease ball and see how it goes tonight.
Perfect.
Hi there. Do you know that I also do radio shows? Who am I kidding? Of course you do. On Wave Radio, Hospital and Community Radio, you can volunteer and be a radio superstar yourself. So it's waveradio.org.uk. Check them out. And you can also be on the interweb and on the radio.
So we're here, we're joined by the undisputed champion of WrestleZone, Scotty Swift. How's it going?
Good. Good to see you, man. Good to be back in Keith. It's been a long time. It's been 3 years.
3 years in Keith.
So it's been a bit of an absence, but we'll make up for it tonight, I hope.
In Keith tonight, and you're not defending your Undisputed Championship. However, I can understand why. Because you're against the Super Executioner.
Yep, I am indeed, yeah. He's different.
Who's boasting no wins?
Apparently, I might be wrong, because memory is bad these days. He might have been on the winning side of a tag team match, but he never actually was the one who picked up the fall. So you could argue he's 1 in 50 or whatever it might be.
Yeah, that, yeah.
But he's never actually beat anyone. So let's just go with that for now.
Yeah, yeah. So you won the title, Aberdeen Anarchy, the biggest show in WrestleZone history, against Joe Coffey. You've had a little bit of a, I wouldn't say... not disappointing, that's definitely not the word, but you've had a little bit of a problem.
It's been a trying couple of months.
Yeah,
so it's the best way to describe that, yeah.
Yeah, with Sterling Oil, of course. A team, a faction you're not unfamiliar with at all, with the history of WrestleZone. But how's it feeling? You've just won the title, it's been quite a while since you've held a singles title mm-hmm. in WrestleZone, and then automatically you were attacked by Sterling Oil. How'd that feel?
Well, when you go, I mean, now you've been to a lot of shows, and I mean, I still class myself as a wrestling fan. I'm still a fan. I still love watching wrestling. The last thing you remember on a show is the last thing in the show. And the last thing at Anarchy should have been, you know, I've won a championship, and hopefully generally the majority is happy with that because I was delighted with it. But the lasting memory of that night will be Sterling Oil. So that big moment, everything I've been working towards, all the hard work, and credit to Joe Coffey, because I mean, you know yourself how good Joe is.
Yeah.
And we both went through a war there. So for the lasting memory of that night to be Sterling Oil is disappointing to me, and I think to a lot of people who were there.
So, it's, I mean, from that point onwards, of course, I don't want to keep speaking about Sterling
Oil. No, okay. I know it's in the atmosphere. Yeah, it's always going to be lingering there.
Yeah,
so.
And of course, and they're specifically targeting yourself, so it can't not speak about it. But so tonight, this is kind of, I wouldn't say a night off, but at least you don't worry it as much.
It's never necessarily a night off when you're going in to have a match with anyone, because wrestling's very dangerous, so whether it's Sterling Oil or Super Executioner, there's still that chance of leaving that show in a worse condition than you were coming in. That's always an issue. It's an issue for absolutely anyone that does this line of work, because it's got its own inherent risks. But it's a change of pace. It'll be a nice change of pace tonight to just concentrate on picking up a win, hopefully making some people happy, including yourself, but it smells people's faces. Haven't been able to do that recently because of what's been happening with Sterling Oil. So tonight in Keith will be a change of pace. Not a night off, but a change of pace.
A
nice change of pace.
I need it,
to be honest with you. Again, it's been a long one.
With only William Sterling in the building, hopefully, because they do like their numbers game.
They travel in a pack, and I think when the pack's been depleted, there's less chance. Not that there's no chance whatsoever, but I like to think is the chance of an attack has went down considerably tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I hope so.
So you're following in the line of undisputed champions such as Johnny Lyons, Brian Tucker, Damien, Crusher Crabe, Joe Coffey, Jack Jester.
Bingo Balance.
Bingo
you
Balance.
Can't forget Bingo.
Oh, can never forget Bingo
he's
Balance.
He's one of my favourites.
He was the first match. He was in the first match I saw of WrestleZone, and it's still the one I always.
Stevie
remember.
Xavier.
Oh yeah. Phenomenal.
Oh yeah, I remember. It was good.
Oh, it was
I heard the crowd. I mean, first having that crowd of that size, and when they started going at it, and I could hear yourself out there and everyone else in the crowd, and it was just I was very excited to get out there at that point.
So, with a long line of great undisputed champions, what do you hope would be your lasting legacy with the belt?
Taking on absolutely anyone. I mean, tonight I'd love to put the belt on the line, but that's not my decision. Put the belt on the line against Mr. Malice. A lot of people were laughing about that, and then Malice shocked us all by putting in quite a shift that night, and more than I expected. Johnny Lyons, obviously, he was a guy who got a shot at the belt. Went in there, Damien and Alan Sterling. I like to be remembered as a guy who never said no to a challenge, never turned anyone away. As far as I'm concerned, anyone can beat anyone on any given night if the stars and moons align for that person. So that's what I like to be remembered as, the guy who would take on absolutely anyone. I'm not going to duck anyone, and I'm here every show. I'll be here defending it.
Perfect. Well, good luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
Of course, when this goes out, I would have already seen the show, so everyone know the results. But
cool.
I think, as I said, if history repeats itself, I can possibly say congratulations on your win.
I know you like Super Executioner.
Oh, I love him.
And so do I, which is why I really don't want to beat him up, because I kind of like the guy. He's harmless in a really annoying kind of way.
Yeah. But thank you very much for taking the time to speak.
You're welcome, man. Thank you very much.
Thanks for listening. That was our interviews with WrestleZone stars that was taking place live in Keith. That was a couple of weeks ago. Great speaking to all of them. Really enjoyed it. So check out WrestleZone. Facebook.com/WrestleZone, I think it is. Also on the website, which is wrestlezonescotland.co.uk. Check out our website, oswtv.wordpress.com, facebook.com/oswtv, on Twitter at voiceofosw, and all the links will be below. So thank you for listening to the OSWTV podcast. I've been Billy. I've been doing ads. Get in touch with me. I want to get everything out there for everyone to hear and see. But thank you for listening. Good night.